Hello students, in the previous class we have observed the miscible liquids, right? So miscible liquids, we have seen azeotropes and their types, that is minimum boiling point and maximum boiling point, and also fractional distillation. So coming to here, partially miscible liquids. So generally what we observe, if liquid is nothing but here, completely soluble, so liquid will be like a true solution, which is a saturated solution we are going to know. But there are some liquids which will not completely dissolve. At certain temperature only they are going to dissolve. So partially is nothing but what here, which the liquids which do not mix in all proportions temperature, that one we call it as what? Partially miscible liquids. So what is partially miscible liquids? Here we are going to say the liquids which are not mixed in all proportions at all temperature, that one we call it as what? Here partially miscible liquids. So the liquids which do not mix in all proportions at all temperatures, we call it as partially miscible liquids. Okay, so here this liquids, which type of liquids we are going to have here? That is, we can take it as phenol water, ether water, aniline water, okay. So see here, phenol water, ether water and aniline water. Okay, so these are the examples we can take it. So when you dissolve phenol in water, so what happens? It is not going to dissolve completely. So at certain temperature only it is going to dissolve. And also if you take ether and also aniline, so for example, I'm saying general example, if you take oil and water, is it soluble in water? No, right? So in the same way, if you take these type of compounds, these are also not soluble. Okay, these are very less soluble. So clearly what we can say here, clearly liquid mixture consists of two liquids. Okay, so what we can say, clearly liquid mixture consists of two layers, that is one or the other. For example, I'm taking phenol and water. So here this is a phenol water system. So here if you have been taken, in this I have mixed both. So let us think, this is a phenol and this is a water. So means what? It is forming two layers. Okay, so this is nothing but phenol water system. For example, if you take a little phenol is added to water at certain temperature, it dissolves completely. If the addition of phenol is continued, then there will be a stage which does not dissolve and it will form the two layers. See, once again I'm saying, if you take very small amount of phenol, when you dissolve it in water, it will completely dissolve. So if you go on adding the phenol, then what happens? It is not going to soluble. There will be a formation of two layers. That is only one, phenol water, phenol, and another layer is water. So this one of the layer we call it as saturated. This one is a organic layer, that this one is a this other this layer what we can say organic layer. So this one we call it as what here? This is a aqueous layer. Okay. So coming to here, in case of aniline and water, if you have been taken, this is also same thing happens. So here the lower layer will be the aniline, upper layer will be the water. So like this, means it consists of two layers, which is known as, so these two layers we call it also known as, we call it as conjugated solutions. Okay, these two layers also we are taking the mixture. Conjugation means what? Combine. So at particular temperature, what happens? These two layers we call it as a conjugation solutions. So these two solutions which is in equilibrium, that one we call it as conjugated solutions at a particular temperature. Then here, depending upon the nature of liquids, to form the miscible layers at particular temperature, we call it as what here? Critical solution temperature. So what we can say here, the temperature at which two partially liquids miscible liquids become completely miscible at all proportions. We call it as what here? Critical solution temperature. Or consolute temperature of the system. So this one we call it as what? Critical solution temperature. So what I have told you clearly, I am saying what here? Phenol water will not dissolve. Okay. So at certain temperature, when you goes on heating this one, so what happens? If you see the temperature, at particular temperature, when you goes on heating, it will become completely miscible. Means when you are heating this phenol and water, it will completely dissolve. Okay. So then it will look like a saturated solution. So this type of thing we call it as critical solution temperature or consolute temperature of the system. So basing upon this, it consists of three types, that is, first one is upper CST, upper critical solution. Second one is lower CST. Third one is both upper and lower CST. Okay, so this is the three types we are going to discuss now. So let us see, first one is upper CST. What is the first one we are going to discuss? Upper CST. Upper critical solution temperature. Okay, so let us take an example of here, phenol water system or water phenol system. Okay, so this is the thing we are going to discuss here. So now let us see here, phenol water system. So you are taking here in a beaker water of 100 ml of water we are taking. Okay, so you have placed here phenol. So this is the phenol. See here, here we are taking 100 ml of water, phenol 80% of phenol we are taking, how much? 2 ml I have taken. So now I am placing a stirrer. I am placing a stirrer inside and also outside. Okay. So this is not in heating condition. So now we are heating this compound. Okay. So I am explaining water phenol system. First of all, see here what I have taken here. 100 ml of water I have taken and 80% of phenol with a 2 ml phenol I have taken. So what I am doing now here, I have placed two stirrers. Okay. So when I am heating this one, so then what happens? I have to stir this compound. Okay. So like this way, if you have to stirring this compound, so then what happens here? When you are stirring this compound, the liquid, so the in the tissue, whatever it is there, the liquid changes into like this turbid. Like dark solution it is going to get. So it is turbid liquid we are going to say in hot condition. At certain temperature. Okay. So when you off this burner, again what happens when you stir this? Again same thing, if you off this burner, when you heat it, then again it is going to get here clear liquid at certain temperature. So then what you are going to get here? Phenol, if you have been taken 2 ml. Water will be constant, that is 100 ml every time you are going to take. And so for example, the turbid temperature will be some 36 degrees centigrade. So the clear liquid temperature will be some 52 degrees centigrade. So the mean you have to take. Okay. Both of these mean we are going to calculate. So by this, what I have been done, water phenol system only I am taking. Okay. So first, in the beaker I have taken 100 ml of water, and in a boiling tube, this one we call it as what here? Boiling tube. In boiling tube I have taken phenol, that is 80% of phenol, that is 2 ml I have taken. Okay, so I have started heating. So when I have started heating and I am continuously stirring, it is forming a turbid liquid in hot condition. So when you turn off the burner, you have to get a clear liquid. So again you start on stirring, then what happens? It will act as a clear liquid, that is 52 degrees centigrade, certain temperature it is giving. Okay, so this is about water phenol system. So like this, how many times you will do? So up to 1 to 8 readings you are going to take, that is up to here some 3 ml, means each time you have to add 1 ml to the water phenol system. Similarly, if you take phenol water system, so same thing happens here. Again you are taking here phenol in this water you are taking. So let us take, this is a water. Okay, so here phenol, so here again you are going to take 2 ml of water. Here we are taking 100 ml of phenol. So this is a boiling tube, again you have kept heating condition. So again what happens? Again you are going to place a stirrers like this. Okay, so then what happens? So this is nothing but water phenol water system. This is a water phenol. Same thing happens. Again you are going to get turbid liquid. Again after heating, if you again stir it, again it is going to get clear liquid. So what we are getting, certain temperatures we are going to note down here. Okay, so here when you goes on noting this temperature, at certain temperature, so let us take on y-axis percentage of water phenol and phenol water Okay, percentage of water phenol and phenol water you are going to take. So here we are going to take temperature. On y-axis we are going to take temperature. On x-axis we are going to take water phenol and phenol water system. So now what happens here? So now what at one side what we are taking water phenol, at another side we are taking phenol water system. So when goes on increasing here, so see here, this is the curve we are getting. At certain this is the what here, water phenol system. So here we are getting here phenol water system. Okay, so this left side indicates what, water phenol. This right side I'm taking phenol water system. So at one point what happens means these two will become completely miscible. That is the temperature we call it as 66 degrees centigrade. At 66 degrees centigrade what happens, the temperature will be completely miscible. Means what here, completely miscible means it is a homogeneous, which will be in a same phase. So this is nothing but upper CSTM. So it is goes on increasing, right? So then it is showing completely miscible, so which is known as what here, homogeneous mixture. So this is nothing but upper CST. So this is the phenol water and water phenol system. This is the example we have been taken. So when means what here, 66 degrees and above, the phenol and water, or water and phenol, will completely miscible in all proportions. It will form a only one layer, that is a single layer, which is known as completely miscible mixture. Okay, so this is upper CST. Now let us see about lower CST. In this we are having different types of examples we can take it, that is phenol water we can take, aniline water we can take, methyl alcohol, cyclohexane, aniline hexane. So this is all we are going to get. So for phenol water we are going to get how much, 66 degrees. If you take aniline water, aniline water system, we are going to get the it is going to mix at 168 degrees centigrade. Okay, so this is one of the example for this. So now let us see about lower CST. Our second type is what here, lower CST. So lower CST is nothing but what here. Here we are going to take an example of for lower CST, water triethylamine. Okay, so this is the example we are taking. Here also same thing happens. So one side you are going to take water triethyl, another side. So here percentage of amine you are going to take, and here we are going to take the temperature. Okay, so here temperature, here percentage of aniline. So first layer what happens, it goes on decreasing. Lower CST means at lower point. Okay, so coming to here, it will be first layer, it will be second layer. So here it goes on decreasing. So this will be a triethylamine water, and this one will be a water triethyl amine. Okay, so this is nothing but what here, lower CST. At certain point what happens means, at certain point it these two layers will become completely miscible. So the temperature we call it as 18.5 degrees centigrade. These two layers will become same process, upper CST how we are doing, in the same way lower CST also we are going to do. But coming to here, it will decrease. Upper CST means the curve will show at the upper part. Here lower CST means the curve will show at the lower part. Okay, so this is nothing but lower CST. And next one we are going to have here, both upper and lower CST. So what we are going to discuss here, both upper and lower CST. Okay, So in this, what happens? Both upper and lower system at two, it will form two layers generally. So see here, I'm taking on x-axis nicotine, percentage of nicotine, and on y-axis I'm taking temperature. Okay, so coming to here, both upper and lower cyst is nothing but percentage of nicotine, and on y-axis temperature I'm taking. So then what happens, what is the example here, what I'm going to take here is nicotine water system. What is the example we are going to take? Water, nicotine system. So this is the example I'm going to take here. So now what happens, actually two sides we are going to have, right? So the first layer is going to decrease and second layer is going to increase. So see here, when you're mixing two layers, so when you're mixing two layers, at one layer, at upper layer, what happens means at 208 degrees centigrade, the water nicotine system will be mixable. And also at lower CST is nothing but here 60.8 degrees centigrade, it is going to mixture. So this one we call it as also critical solution temperature. Okay, this is the upper layer, this is the lower layer. So this is nothing but nicotine water system or water nicotine system. At one side we are taking water nicotine, at other side we are taking nicotine water system. So means what here? Here at certain temperature at 208 degrees, these two layers when they are traveling, so here what happens, at third bit it is going to form 208 degrees, at again it is forming 60 point, means at this temperature these two layers will become completely miscible, and also at lower part also it can become completely miscible. So this is nothing but both upper and lower CST. Okay, so here this is about partially miscible liquids. So we are going to have effect of impurity on consolute temperature. So what is effect of impurity on consolute temperature is nothing but here, so when you take any substance, so up to now we have taken only water, so out of these two any third compound is not going to add here. Okay, see here, I'm saying for example if two persons are talking, only the two persons will talk. If one more person is, means from outside he is coming, one more person means the third person is coming. In the same way, effect of impurity on consolute temperature is nothing but here, between the two compounds the other substance is coming and influencing the temperature. That one we call it as effect of impurity on consolute temperature. So out of these two, for example water nicotine I have taken, if I add aniline to this system, so then what happens, it will give faster temperature to become completely miscible. Okay, so this is nothing but effect of impurity on consolute temperature. So what we can say here, so the critical solution temperature or consolute temperature is influenced by presence of any foreign substance or impurity. That one we call it as effect of impurity on consolute temperature. So what we can say here, the consolute temperature or CST is influenced by presence of any foreign substance
or impurity. This one we call it as effect of impurity on solute temperature. Okay, so means what happened? Example, let us take phenol water. So here the critical solution of phenol water is increased by 20 degrees. How it is increasing? If you add 1% of acetic acid or aniline, by adding naphthalene to the phenol water system, it increases 20 degrees centigrade. So example, what we can take here? By addition of molar of concentration of naphthalene to 20 ml of phenol water, so by this what we can say here, it is going to increase 20% of temperature. So this is the third. In phenol water system, what we are adding, up to now we have seen only phenol water system. At 66 degrees, it is going to become completely miscible. So when you add naphthalene to this phenol water, so it can easily dissolve the phenol water system. So this is nothing but what here? Effect of impurity on solute temperature. So in the next class, we can see the immiscible liquids. Thank you.